ladies and gentlemen, need no introduction. You best Booker T. Let's give him a big round of applause.
I think I'm best known for making organ instrumental songs, namely Green Onions and Time is Tight and Hip Hugger. Good time, danceable music that people can sort of forget their troubles with.
In terms of just kind of explaining how we're approaching the record with Booker is really not recreating what Booker has done in the past, but really trying to fuse the fundamentals of what real music used to be and infuse that with today's sound sonically, and kind of how Booker interacts within songs with artists like Anthony Hamilton singing vocals and Gary Clark Jr. We're actually just trying to fuse something together that was done in the past and make it now.
We got a long road and a short time to get there. So take a load off and waltz off today.
What's it like to play on Booker T's album? It's amazing.
We're kind of just introducing him to a new, you know, generation.
It's an incredible experience working with Booker. He's a legend for a reason.
It's quite inspirational to see how humble, how grounded he is as an individual.
You don't really get an opportunity to work with a living legend very many times in your career.
He doesn't force anything. He just sits in the pocket. And I can't think of too many people like that, you know, who can lead a band with that kind of vibe.
It's been the best experience ever.
You feeling that, Booker?
Yeah.
That stank on it.
I got an idea for it.
The sound of this record is new for me, and it's something that I always like to try to do with a new project. It's fresh, it's different, it's still Booker T music. All the sounds are originating from new and different sources, so it won't sound like anything I've done before, but it will sound the same.
What's happening, man? Like a dead man walking, and I'ma keep on stalking.
I knew immediately when he sent me the song that was the one that I needed to be involved in. It has what I call that filthy McNasty. So it was right in the pocket for me.
I keep on melting.
The last song that I worked on was actually written by me for Gary Clark Jr. to play on.
I was told that he had me in mind when he was writing it, so I felt pretty special. It's kind of a low-down, cool atmosphere. That's what it makes me think of.
Gary came in and just like a Rembrandt or a Leonardo da Vinci came in and put the touches in just the right places and just the right times with the beautiful colors, as only Gary could do. I'm evolving as a person and a musician. I've had a long and distant past, but now I'm changing. I'm moving on to different types of music, different rhythms, different colors. This album sort of embodies a number of those different concepts for me. The Avila Brothers brought this new idea to come to pass. They're the ones that are responsible for the new sound. The sort of connection with the new generation has been through them.
If I can capture that Stax feeling that really captivated me in terms of just listening to Booker T. Everybody played a Hammond B3 in those days, but no one played it like Booker T.
And I feel like this album has become a work of art, but I have just come to have faith that when we arrive at the session with the right people, that magic is going to somehow fall down into the room, and it does.
The one thing that music lacks today is feeling and emotion. And I think working with Booker T, that's what you get. You get emotion.
Started out on Stax Records, and I had a great beginning there that I could never have imagined when I was growing up in Memphis, that I would have a successful record at age 17 and a career in the music business. I thought I would be, at best, a music teacher, which I would have been happy with. But I went on to work with, you know, Booker T and the MGs, and Wilson Pickett and Eddie Floyd and Sam and Dave and Carla Thomas, and it's been 40 years and it's here again. I'm very thankful for that.
up until the evening, gently.